हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वेल टुडे हियर आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ यूनिट 5, द चैप्टर नंबर 14। सो आवर टॉपिक इज मैटर। मैटर मीन्स, एज यू नो दैट there are different substances, there are different objects, you can say, in the universe there are many different types of substances that has weight and occupies space. That has weight, that means mass, okay, and they also occupies some space, that means cover some space, whether it is an invisible gas or a gigantic star. Clear? They may be invisible gas or a gigantic star. Anything that has weight and occupies a space is called matter. Matter means any object, any substance that has some mass, some weight, and they occupy some space. Okay, here you can see there are different types of substances like petrol, paint, lemonade, milk, teeth, juice, helium, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, oxygen, bread, van, soap, whatever. So we can say that these all are substances and they have some weight and they occupy space. They occupy space. Clear? So they are in the three forms. They are in three forms, like solids, liquids, gases. Some are maybe in solids states, liquid states, and some are in gases. Okay, so all these substances can be classified into three categories means solids, liquids, and gases. So let's recall, you all are also aware that everything in the universe has weight and occupies a space, whether it is an invisible gas. It may be invisible gas, that means we cannot see such type of gas, that means oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, whatever. Okay, anything that has weight and occupies a space is called matter. MATTER. So this is called matter. Matter is all around you. All around you. The food you eat, this book also you are reading from, the air you are breathing, everything is matter. Everything is matter. It may be food, book, or air. Clear? Then why is there such a lot of difference between the three states of matter? Here question is arising, why is there such a lot of difference between the three states of matter? Why? Because all substances, all ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर मेड अप ऑफ टाइनी एटम्स. टाइनी मीन्स सो स्मॉल, वेरी स्मॉल. मैटर इज मेड अप ऑफ टाइनी पार्टिकल्स कॉल्ड एटम्स. दीज आर सो स्मॉल दैट वी कैन नॉट सी देम. ओके, फाइंड आउट हाउ मैनी एटम्स कैन फिट इंटू दिस फुल स्टॉप. सपोज दैट दिस फुल स्टॉप इज गिवेन हियर. नाउ यू फाइंड आउट हाउ मैनी एटम्स कैन बी फिट हियर. दीज एटम्स यूजली ज्वाइन टूगेदर इन स्मॉल ग्रुप्स कॉल्ड मॉलिक्यूल्स. एटम्स यूजली ज्वाइन टूगेदर इन स्मॉल ग्रुप्स कॉल्ड मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो मॉलिक्यूल्स इज स्मॉलर देन, सो स्मॉलर देन एटम्स. वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स इज मेड अप मेड फ्रॉम अ पेयर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन. पेयर मीन्स टू पीसेस. पेयर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम्स ज्वाइंट टू एन ऑक्सीजन एटम. सो द कंपोजिशन इज H2+O=H2O. नंबर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन एटम इज टू एंड नंबर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एटम इज वन. सो कंपोजिशन इज H2. दैट मीन्स वाटर. दिस इज केमिकल फॉर्मूला ऑफ वाटर. क्लियर. इट इज हाउ द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर पैक्ड और अरेंज्ड विच डिफाइन्स वेदर द सबस्टांस इज अ सॉलिड, अ लिक्विड और अ गैस. दैट मीन्स these atoms and you can say molecules are packed or arranged which defines whether the substance is a solid, a liquid or a gas. That's why we can say that all substances can be classified into three categories. That means some are solids, some may be liquids, and some other substances are in gaseous form. Okay? So, due to molecules are packed or arranged which defines whether the solid, liquid or gas. So solids have a definite shape and volume and do not flow. The property of solid is they have definite shape and volume and do not flow. A rock, for example, a rock will always remain a rock unless you break it by applying pressure or any other external force. Solids can be hard, soft, big, small, okay, like grains of sand. The molecules in a solid are very tightly packed. You can see here, solids are packed tightly, very tightly, and held together in extremely strong bonds, not weak. Okay, there is just no space in solids, the molecules between the molecules, there is no any space for them to move, and this is what gives them their fixed shape. Okay? Solids are closely packed, you can say tightly packed, and they have no any space for that to move, and this is what gives them their fixed shape. Okay. Is the salt we eat also a solid? Tell me. Salt is in solid form. Of course. So guys, please, you all of you, read this topic carefully and write down all difficult words and learn properly. Okay? Next day we will explain the liquids and gases. Okay? Thank you very much.